Imagine you're watching Finding Nemo, except this time, Nemo isn't taken away by scuba divers. Rather, this time, he is caught in a current and trapped into a big trash pile. His father must race to find him, but the amount of trash is so large that Marlin must check almost every pile to find his son. In one pile, he finds Dory, and she agrees to help him find his son. Even with the extra help, they cannot seem to find Nemo. They check everywhere they can, but this story does not have the same happy ending that Finding Nemo has. This new story has the same ending as many of the marine life today. There are 5 major garbage piles in the world's oceans. The largest one is 2.8 million square miles, which is larger than the entire United States. And right now, there's 5.25 trillion pieces of plastic debris in the ocean. Every year, there's 8 million tons of plastic dumped into the world's oceans. And every year, more and more ocean creatures are dying and becoming endangered. This is all because of us humans. We have been dumping our waste into the ocean and just pretending it has disappeared and we won't have to deal with it ever again. If we keep believing this, we are going to be hit in the face when we realize we do have to deal with it. In the ocean, there are currently 1.98 million species of marine life. 2,300 of those are currently on the endangered list. Many of the animals see trash and believe it is food. Many of them eat it because of the lack of food or it is the only food in the area. The problem with this is that they may eat the trash, which causes issues inside the animal. The trash can cut up their mouths, plug up their internal organs, and most often kills them. We also dump oil into the ocean. This oil suffocates the animals because they cannot get the oxygen out of the water. The oil also affects the insulation of the coats of animals such as otters. When the animals clean themselves, some ingest the oil, which becomes like poison. Fish may experience reduced growth, enlarged livers, changes in heart and respiration rates, fin erosion, and reproduction impairment. It can also affect the survival of eggs and larvae by inhibiting growth. The way to fix this is to make the issue more known. The way to make it more known is to post things on social media, websites, and by passing on the word. Another way to fix the issue is to fundraise. People could sell things like keychains, bracelets, hats, or even just a fundraising page where anyone could donate. Another way is to limit trash use. This may sound crazy because it may not feel like we're producing much waste, but in reality, the average American produces 4.4 pounds of trash each day. We should also be limiting the trash use of large companies. Nowadays, everything is packaged in plastic. From candy bars to action figures, it is most likely covered in or is plastic. There could be a limit on how much of the packaging is plastic or other non-biodegradable materials. For example, California recently took a step in the right direction by outlawing free plastic bags. This forced consumers to bring their own plastic bags and create less waste. What seems a small step like this can make a huge difference in the long run. Lastly, we could be cleaning up the oceans more. The Environmental Protection Agency, or EPA, has a budget and much of it is already devoted to ocean cleanup. This means we should be cleaning up trash we see on the coast or anywhere else. Also, the EPA's budget is only to protect the waters of America, but this is a global issue. We should be making an effort with other countries to fix our Earth. We are going to be here forever and we may not see the effects of this now, but we will in the future. Some don't care because, well, we all die at some point, but we must think of our posterity and more to come. I said species right!
Who's your daddy?